الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة
something that we all want, and that is love. We expect it from our families and the people whom we care about. But do we ever realize where this love comes from and the one who created this love? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most deserving of our love. So today I wanted to go over our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how we know of Allah's love. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in Surah Al-Hajj in Ayah 46, He says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم أفلم يسيروا في الأرض Have they not traveled throughout the land? فتكون لهم قلوب يعقلون بها So their hearts may reason أو آذان يسمعون بها So their ears may listen فإنها لا تعمى الأبصار For indeed it is not their eyes that are blind فإنها لا تعمى الأبصار ولكن ولكن تعمى القلوب التي في الصدور except that it is their hearts and their chests that will grow blind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is مقلب القلوب, the turner of hearts. Those whom Allah loves, He turns their hearts towards Islam. Remember the story of the second Khalif of Islam, Umar radiallahu ta'ala. He went sword in hand to kill the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And now, when you think about this story, this is not no ordinary man. This is Umar. No one could stop this man in a fight or battle. And his intention was to what? To kill the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. On his way, Umar heard his sister reciting the opening verses of Surah Taha. Following that, he became a Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came between Umar and his heart. He went to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that day and he took a shahada. I'm sure that some of you have seen so much stories on social media about their own experiences of people coming to Islam. Remember, it is not us, it's not our clever debates or our intellect that bring people towards Islam. It's Allah. Allah chooses whom He guides for His religion. So many non-Muslims have studied theology, have studied Islam in colleges and in universities. This brings them nothing except for degrees and the people call them professors. But so many Muslims, they don't know that much about their religion, but they still have that spark of Islam and Iman in their hearts. That knowledge earns people doctorates and professorships that will be no use to them in the afterlife. So you and I must be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that with the little about Islam that we know, that there is a spark of Iman in our hearts. Allah has lit the light of Iman in our hearts that we are here attending Jumu'ah today. That is His love. No matter how much sin or wrongdoing we have done, He still invites us to His house on this day. Our hearts can turn from good to bad in an instant and from bad to good. The only way that you and I can ensure that our hearts are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is by dhikrullah, by saying subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, glory to Allah, praise to Allah, Allah is the greatest, la ilaha illallah, there is none worthy of worship except for Allah. Day in and day out, dhikrullah is the key to avoiding distractions and forgetting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The love that you give your brothers and sisters is nothing compared to the love that Allah has for you. If you knew the love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has for each and every single one of us, we would all cry an ocean of our own. That is the love of Allah, something that we cannot comprehend and something that we cannot take for granted. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, wa afdhalu as-salati wa atammu at-taslim ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. In Sahih Muslim, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, her mother, said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever loves to meet Allah, Allah loves to meet him. And whoever hates to meet Allah, Allah hates to meet him. I said, O Prophet of Allah, all of us hate death and are averse to it, meaning that we don't like it. The Prophet said, no, it is not like this. Rather, when a believer is given glad tidings of the mercy and the rahmah of Allah, his pleasure in paradise, he loves to meet Allah and Allah loves to meet him. When a disbeliever is given the news of punishment by the hand of Allah and hardship to be imposed by him, he hates to meet Allah and Allah hates to meet him. So how can we truly love Allah? In a hadith Qudsi, the formula is given on the authority of Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said, who said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whosoever shows enemy to someone devoted to me, I shall be at war with him. My servant draws near to me with nothing more loved by me than the religious duties, so his obligations, his salat, his fasting, I have enjoyed upon him, and my servant continues to draw near with me with supurgatory, which means the sunan, which means extra small little acts. And when I love him, I am his hearing, which he hears, his seeing, which he sees, his hand, which he strikes with, and his foot, which he walks. Were he to ask of me for something, I would surely give it to him. I would surely grant it to him. And if were he to ask me for refuge, I would surely grant it to him, and I do not hesitate about anything as much as I hesitate about seizing the soul of my faithful servant, as he hates death and I hate hurting him. It was related by Al-Bukhari. Look around you. Every single one of us are brothers and sisters in Islam today. We are a sign of Allah's love and mercy. When you take a breath in, that is Allah. How can you not love Allah, the one who has given you everything, when you deserve nothing, when you were created from nothing, when you were nothing and you had no value? He gave you that value. He values you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, take one step towards me, I will take 10 steps towards you. Walk towards me and I will run towards you. This is the formula to love Allah. Take a small step, start out small. Do your obligations and then start to increase slowly. As day by day, as your love for your Rabb increases, His love will increase for you too as well, inshallah. When you have Allah's love, you have everything. We want to be loved by everyone in this world. We want people to respect us. We want people to look up to us. But I think this is the true formula to it. For indeed, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves a servant, He calls upon Jibreel alayhi salam. And He says, "Ya Jibreel, I love so and so. So now you must love him. So love him, Ya Jibreel." So then Jibreel alayhi salam says he loves you. So then you have Allah, the Creator, who loves you, and His main angel loving you. Then Allah says, no, that's not enough. It's not enough for you to love him. You have to make the other angels love him as well. Then all of the malaika are notified that, yo, you have to love him. He has to know you. You have to love this person. And then Allah says, no, that is not enough. Make it so that the Rabbul Alameen, everyone in this world, loves you. And that is how we get people to love us. That is where our love comes from. رَبَّنَا أَتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا وَكَفِّرْ عَنَّا سَيِّئَاتِنَا وَتَوَفَّنَا مَعَ الْأَبْرَارِ رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ جَامِعُ النَّاسِ لِيَوْمٍ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ إِنَّكَ لَا تُخْلِفُ الْمِيعَادَ عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وأقيموا الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله هيا للصلاة هيا للفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
قد أفلح المؤمنون الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون والذين هم عن اللغو معرضون والذين هم للزكاة فاعلون والذين هم لفروجهم حافظون
إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين فمن ابتغى وراء ذلك فأولئك هم العادون والذين هم لأماناتهم وعهدهم راعون والذين هم على صلواتهم يحافظون أولئك هم الوارثون الذين يرثون الفردوس هم فيها خالدون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
ولقد خلقنا الإنسان من سلالة من طين ثم جعلناه نطفة في قرار مكين ثم خلقنا النطفة علقة فخلقنا العلقة مضغة فخلقنا المضغة عظاما فكسونا العظام لحما ثم أنشأناه خلقا آخر فتبارك الله أحسن الخالقين ثم إنكم بعد ذلك لميتون ثم إنكم يوم القيامة تبعثون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.